How would you describe your favorite artist? She makes awesome music, he's a man of kindness, she's super good looking, or he's a lovely father. There are many reasons for us to appreciate a person, and most celebrities, besides doing what they're good at, work hard on their image to make themselves even more likable. But sometimes the truth could be ugly. So here comes an interesting question. How much can you appreciate a talented douchebag? Hey everyone, it's Terry and welcome back to my channel. Here in this channel, I talk about dance music, basically just everything about festivals, DJs, and EDM. So make sure you hit that subscribe button if you haven't already and turn on notifications so you get notified every time I upload a new video. So today, let's talk about an interesting topic. How much can you appreciate a talented douchebag? This question has been on my mind for a while since the Dasik incident happened back in 2018. But back then, I haven't really got a place to talk about it. So following my video from last week about the Anthrum, I think it's a good time to bring this up into discussion. So first, I'll talk about the Dasik incident just in case a lot of you guys are not very familiar with this. So back in 2018, when the Me Too movement was at its peak, dubstep superstar Dasik was called out by people on Facebook accusing him of sexually assaulting a girl who was completely incoherent. Dasik was actually one of the most popular dubstep artists at that time, and his Ninja Tour was quite on fire. However, things went down pretty quickly after multiple sexual assault allegations was made. In a Facebook comment, a fan talked in detail how Dasik's manager gave out passes that marked Tulsa, which read backwards as a slut, to his friend, took her to the backstage, gave her so much alcohol until she could not manage herself, then had sex with the girl when she was unable to consent. And by definition, this was a rape. A person further talked about how his friend was left without any underwear in the winter, with vomit all over her body, all by herself after the rape. After this, multiple people stood out to call out Dasik for doing the same thing many, many times. It seems like they gave out the Tulsa passes to fangirls who believed they had won a meet and greet with the cool artist. But what the artist did was sexually assault them after they'd gone drunk. Another victim wrote to EDM.com describing how she completely blacked out in the bathroom of Dasik's hotel and waking up just to find him raping herself before going unconscious again. When she finally woke up in pain the next day, she found that her tampon from the day before was not even removed when it all happened, which was extremely dangerous. When she tried to contact the artist's management company, Dexter, along with their friend who was also a victim, they were almost immediately contacted by a PR firm who asked them, "What is it that you're looking for?" When they said they wanted an apology letter from Dasik, things went completely silent. And EDM.com tried to look for more information from the PR firm, but the firm replied that they had no contract with Dasik Management Company and was not responsible for the following ups of the allegations. Dasik's career came to a halt after this. He was dropped by the record label, the booking company, and his own management company. All his shows were either canceled or dropped. And the artist himself disappeared. However, during that whole time, no one had ever really responded or confirmed these allegations, not even Dasik himself. When he finally came back on social media after 18 months of silence, releasing a seemingly apology video in which he talked about how he was dealing with some mental problems and would start making music again, he still left the allegations untouched. While in terms of law, no one is guilty until proven, sexual assault cases are usually a little bit more complicated to deal with. On the other hand, if Dasik didn't do any of those things, a firm denial or even saying that they would pursue legal actions seemed to be more like it. The response from Dasik just made people wonder if he was just trying to let it die if no one on his side ever really touched the topic or admitted anything. People were not offering a lot of positive feedbacks, of course, but there was really not much of a conclusion we could jump to when nothing was really legally proven. While the truth is probably impossible to find now, here comes an interesting question. If your favorite artist, let's say, did something that's ethically wrong, but you really enjoy his or her music, will you still support the artist and his creations? I used to study literature when I was in college, so if you know a little bit about art, there are plenty of talented jerks in the history of art. Back in 2017, when the Me Too movement was at the top of the waves, Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein was accused of sexual misconduct by more than 90 women. And just so you know, 3 weeks ago, he was sentenced to prison for 23 years. This made the so-called Weinstein effect, in which 262 famous and powerful men around the world were taken down all at once. And more scandals were disclosed involving some of our familiar names, like action star Sylvester Stallone, R&B singer R. Kelly, and the prominent director Luke Besson, who made The Fifth Element and Lucy. Just like how Daszak was an important part of dubstep music, these people were very, very important figures in the movie or music industry. It's beyond doubt that they were gifted with remarkable talent. But are we supposed to be supporting them or their work when we know that they have done all the misconduct? I would very much like to know your thoughts, so I'll start by sharing mine. So if you watched my previous video, you probably can tell that I do care about being responsible, especially when it comes to something like sexual violence and assault. And for me, there's a line that marks my standard. So I don't judge a person by the things above that line. However, if he or she does something that falls under the line, well, the person basically loses accountability for me. So for example, if an actor has three girlfriends at the same time, which is probably not quite morally correct, that's not something I would take to judge a person's artistic achievement. But if someone sexually abuses other people, it's not acceptable for me. So as you guys can probably guess, even if I do play bass music when I DJ, I never ever play Daszak's music and I don't listen to his stuff either. But of course, this is just my thoughts. Some might take a different side and say morality shouldn't be a factor to judge a person's artistic achievements. So for example, Hitler was actually a pretty talented painter, and of course we can appreciate his work too. So everyone has his own standards, and I'm not really here to judge or score or criticize anyone, but I feel like it's now a really good time to discuss, to debate, or even to reevaluate your standards. So leave a comment down below to share your ideas. Do you think we should support the artist and his creations when he really does something that's really fucked up? Or do you think artists and celebrities have their social responsibility? Or like, how much social responsibility should a person have on his shoulders? If an artist has more responsibility on him, then does a fan, who is a less effective person, can thus just listen to whatever music he likes because it doesn't have that much responsibility? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. And that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give me a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. You can also go ahead and follow me on my socials so you don't miss anything from me. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Wait, we're not in focus. We're not in focus. How would you describe your favorite artist? She makes awesome music? Wait. Hey, I'm recording, okay?